So here is tur dal, which is called arhar dal also, which I have soaked in a water. So I am going to add some onions. It's like roughly chopped, I would say. And I am adding like a quarter onion in this. Few cloves of garlic. I would say around 3 to 4 cloves of garlic here. Add around 1.5 teaspoon of salt. Turmeric powder, like a half teaspoon of turmeric powder. And here goes drumsticks. So I'm adding around 4 to 5 drumsticks. I have frozen drumsticks. If you have fresh, go ahead and use that. So after adding drumsticks, cover the lid of your Instapot and let it run on manual for 7 minutes, and then we will check back our dal in 7 minutes. In the meanwhile, we'll go ahead and prepare our tadka. So here is my pan ready. Here goes 1 tablespoon of oil. Let it heat up. Here goes some mustard seeds. So around 1/2 teaspoon of mustard seeds. Here goes jeera, around 1 teaspoon of jeera. Oil is nicely heated up. Let it splutter, and then along with this, here goes more garlic. I had like 3 to 4 cloves of garlic added in my tur dal earlier in the cooker. Here goes around 3/4 medium sized onions. Just mix it, let it cook for 3 to 4 minutes until it's light brown. Around a pinch of hing here, which is called asafoetida too. So my onions are done. It took me like 3 minutes. It's light brown. Now I'm going to add my veggies. Here goes green beans, okra, which is called bhindi, 3 carrots. 3 baby carrots actually. Here goes loki. So just give it a stir. Let this cook for another 5 to 7 minutes. So I just wanted to call out, some of my veggies here are frozen. Like my loki is frozen here. So when I don't have loki and I wanted to make sambar, sometimes I keep frozen loki, frozen bottle gourd. And it's so handy for me to add in my sambar. That's the reason many times I add frozen loki. I cut it and, you know, just keep it as frozen. If you have fresh, go ahead and put fresh in here. And here goes tomatoes, around 2.5 medium sized tomato here. And I will just mix it well, and I will just cover the lid for this to get cooked for another 10 minutes. So here goes curry leaves. My veggies are cooking from last 3 to 4 minutes. We need this to be cooked for another 7 to 8 minutes. I'll just add all the spices here. Here goes sambar powder. You can use any type of sambar powder. Right now I have handy Eastern. So use MDH, use whatever you have handy. I have added around a tablespoon of this with some red chili powder, as we added turmeric and salt already into our dal, so I am skipping that. So I'll just cover this with a lid, and you know, we'll check in another 5 to 7 minutes. So just wanted to call out, please cook this on low to medium flame so that it does not get burnt. If you want and you feel like water is required, just add water. I'm just cooking without water. So here Subji is cooking from last 10 minutes, I would say, or so. Just mix it well. If you think that you need some water in the Subji, just go ahead and add it. And again, make sure to cook this veggies on low to medium flame. And here is my cooked dal. I'm just going to add it here. Cooked in Instapot for 7 minutes on manual. So I'm just going to mix this together. And there is another last ingredient which goes on top of it, that is tamarind. So here goes around a teaspoon of tamarind paste. So I'm using tamarind tamikon concentrate. For now, I'm just using 1 teaspoon. You can use it based on your taste. If you want more tangy, add it a little bit more. And now I'm just going to add 1/2 cup more water to this and let it cook on medium flame for another 5-10 minutes on low to medium flame. So make sure to mix it well and then add water to this. So here goes 1/2 cup water. And I'm just going to cover this with the lid and cook it for another 5-10 minutes. So I just did a taste test. I added a little bit more salt, around 1/2 teaspoon of more salt, some sambar powder, and some more tamarind paste. So don't worry if you see this foam on the top, that is not a problem. It's because we boiled dal in that cooker. That's the reason we have that foamy. So don't worry about it. Let's cook it for another 10 minutes. So look at this. This is cooking from last 10 minutes, I would say. And this is nicely gelled up with my dal and sabjis together. So that's it. Sambar is ready in no minutes. So there are 2 ways I make sambar. One is I boil all the vegetables along with dal. That way it's easy. And when I'm making it for party or something, I make it this way where I cook the vegetables separately from dal. And then put this in the pan or put it in the cooker, whatever you are comfortable with. And then cook it for a while. Let everything gel together. And this is ready. So look at this. It's ready to go on the plate. So try out my sambar recipe. Leave me comments. Leave me suggestions. Don't forget to hit the like button and subscribe on our channel for more videos. And yes, we are coming on Facebook and Instagram too. So please keep watching and follow us on Instagram too. Thank you so much. Have a wonderful day. Bye bye.